Welcome. So my initial first impressions of EA's PGA Tour is that it looks better, it feels better, but I find it incredibly difficult in comparison to PGA 2K23. I didn't notice in PGA 2K23 having the ability to see that arc. I really appreciate, you know, the white triangle is where you're aiming, but with the predicted situation that you're in and the wind, the blue arc is actually where you're more than likely to have the ball go. Just the whole swing in 2K I find is incredibly fast. I don't know if that can be changed, okay? Both settings are on low difficulty. And when we just go into it, I don't know. There's just something about it, especially with that spin, the ability to do the post spin ball, for me, that's huge. The grass, which is what you spend 90% of the time looking at with your eyes, it just looks better. And yes, I have commentary off. I forget if I've mentioned that. So for me, as a casual scrub playing golf, I'm left feeling annoyed because of my own inabilities. And I think the biggest reason why I find the game so difficult, which I can actually explain, and perhaps it can be addressed. Let's take a look at this, for example. I'm predicted to hit the ball right. See, I can't go back. I can only go forward. Can't go back unless I switch to a different club. Let's say I'm predicted to hit the ball here where the blue arc goes, okay? And I go full swing. Normally in a golf game, at least the ones I've played with the settings that are on, the ball would never really go much past there. I mean, it could a little bit. In this game, oh my God, if I go full, I'm going to hit the crowd. So it's like, that's the part where I'm confused about, and I have the game pretty much on the easiest setting. So let's go ahead and take a look at that, actually. We're going to go ahead, change the camera. Not that that really matters. So that was not like a complete full hit swing. I mean, that one wasn't too terrible, but the result overall is that for me, I'm getting double bogeys after double bogeys in this game, whereas I'm getting pars and eagles in PGA 2K23. Right? So, but again, this is not a knock on this game. And this is on the easiest setting again. That's kind of like important to note. Maybe I got to learn how to change my chip shots. Maybe a chip shot isn't good. Maybe I need to do a flop. Maybe I need to learn how to, you know, put the backspin on my ball or something, or just not go as strong. But the idea for me is if I go full swing, I shouldn't be going much further than here. However, let's see what happens. And maybe it's just a part of the design here. See, look at how far that went. I did that on purpose, actually. Had I done that in another game, it wouldn't have had the chance to go 22 feet nearly from the hole. So now I'm left really having to figure out what's going on. The putt replay or the putt reading is automatic. I am not aware of how to do it again. This is based on if you were just to take a shot right now. So naturally for this, you wouldn't just like shoot. You would have to kind of like, you know what I mean? Like, I'm not saying I know exactly how to do this. But now once you adjust, there doesn't appear to be any way whatsoever to read where the ball would now go. And that scratching thing that sounds like somebody's like rubbing their hands together drives my OCD absolutely fucking bonkers. I have my moments. I have my moments, just like my Batman video that I did yesterday where I took an amazing shot. So it's like, take this as you will. I feel like everybody, beginner, like myself, noob, someone that doesn't really invest too much time in golf games because I'm all over the place on my channel. I feel like it's still important for me to share my thoughts on what I think. It's like I want to play PGA 2K23 because I can get eagles and pars. And I want to play this game because it looks and feels better. But I'm tired of getting double bogeys. So people could just say, get good, bruh. Maybe, but holy shit. Right? Like arcade easy or whatever it is. If we go ahead and take a look at that really quick, I think we can change the gameplay here. So I have it on the easiest difficulty. Whoops. Let's start with the... let's start at the bottom. Elevation, sure. Direction and amount of elevations displayed. The wind reading is showing. Wind gust doesn't take effect in terms of the speed to fluctuate. Putting grid's on. Putt read is on. Putting aim point, it's on assisted aim. Amounts for uphill, downhill slope to preset the aim marker to a logical distance for the putt. Aiming arc, we got the full one so we could see the full potential trajectory of the ball. Zoom is on. We even turned off the lie effect. We turned off shot shaping. Spin control's on. Power boost is on. Swing meter's on. Putting difficulty's on easy. Swing is on easy. Okay? And... like, this game does a good job of essentially humbling you, at least myself, right? So again, let's go ahead and just do like another hole. So the ball is predicted to go roughly where the blue arc is. We'll go with that and hope that... See, I went past the 100 mark. There's two lines there, if you've noticed. See, that wasn't too god-awful of a shot there. At least I don't think so. How I fare off after, if I even bother. See that? Shh. I don't know. It happens a lot, and it drives me batshit crazy. So here we're going to project for about the middle, in between the water and in between the sand. Whoops, did that work? Yeah, it did. Okay, it kept it. Let's go ahead. Let's look at different views there. Again, I went past the marker, and I get that. And that might be detrimental to my success. However, it ended up being a good shot, but a terrible shot in that it didn't really go where it was projecting to go because I overemphasized, if that makes any sense. And I think... holy shit, yeah. And I think... yeah, there's no way I'm sinking a near 100-foot putt. Anyways, so that's that. I don't even know how to read this, to be honest. For me, that's not too bad. Not too bad. Just, I don't know, it just drives me nuts. See, this again would mean that I kind of have to... ooh, that might not even make it. Yeah, see? I have a hard time sometimes reading that. Because what would have happened in PGA 2K is I would have naturally have tried to move, and then I would have done my putt preview. So it's a different way of doing things. And I felt like it was important to share what I've shared with you today. And as a result, I'm not going to lie, I am now on the fence of buying it. I don't know if I should just buy it, ditch PGA 2K, because I enjoy how this feels and looks better, despite the fact that I completely suck, and hope that I get better. Because this is now, for me, feeling like... save the round. It is feeling like the Elden Ring, the Dark Souls of golf games. Like, I have a much easier time in PGA 2K, but this also has some really cool features. Ball trails, swing trails. You could buy some tracers for when you swing the club or the ball. I don't think you can do that in 2K23. If that kind of stuff matters to you, that little bling, for me, it's actually really cool. If you don't know what I'm talking about, you can edit your golfer there. See? Smoke. Oh, now it's smoke ball trail. You can even do a smoke club trail. They got a bunch of different featured stuff there that you can do. And I just think that it's really intriguing. So I think this is a very solid game. But for me, I do not find it to be beginner friendly. Maybe there's just something terribly wrong with me and I need to work on not always going past like the max, if that makes any sense. I wish there was a way to have it so that it caps it at that first line, which is your 100%, not going 110% or whatever, because that would aid in not the ball going countless amounts of yards past a projected, you know, guess of where the ball is going to go. Maybe this video was of some use. Maybe it was completely useless. Whatever. It happens. If you like the video, go ahead, give it a thumbs up. I mean, it does greatly help support the channel with the algorithm in making me more relevant in the search results when people are looking shit up. If you didn't like the video, go ahead, give it a thumbs down, and I'll bend it in half, twist it, break a club off in your ass. And if you want to subscribe to the channel, I mean, naturally, that would be great. But if not, thanks for stopping by anyways. Take care. And perhaps I shall see some of you in the next one. As you could tell, I've now played 3 hours, just 10 minutes shy of, or 9 minutes shy of 3 hours on the game. So I felt like I've played it enough to kind of get a feel, as I've said, to compare to this game here, which I just started playing. And I've got 4 hours in. So 4 hours in on 2K23. And I've got 3 hours in on this, and that's why it's called a first impression, not a deep dive, in-depth, analytical ACG fucking review, okay? Anyways, take care, and perhaps I shall see some of you in the next one. Bye for now.